Now we are going to discuss Fourier series of f of x in minus pi comma plus pi using even and odd nature of the given function f of x. You just recall even nature of the given function f of x in minus pi comma plus pi with the help of property of definite integral. You recall that is integral minus a to plus a f of x dx is equal to 2 times of integral 0 to a f of x dx if f of x is even. F of x dx integral minus a to plus a is equal to 0 if f of x is odd. With the help of this property of definite integral, we confirm the given function f of x is even. It satisfies the condition, you know, f of minus x is equal to f of x is odd, f of minus x is equal to minus f of x. Using this condition, the given function f of x is even, we find only a naught and an. The given function is odd, we find only bn. The formula for finding a naught is equal to 2 by pi integral 0 to pi, not 1 by pi integral minus pi to plus pi. See here, the given is in the form of minus pi to plus pi f of x dx is equal to 2 times. That is why here 2 times 1 by pi integral, here 0 to a is there. That is why here you write 0 to pi. So a naught formula, after confirming the given function f of x is even, a naught is equal to 2 by pi integral 0 to pi f of x into dx. An formula is 2 by pi integral 0 to pi f of x into cos nx. Obviously bn is equal to 0. So we conclude the given function f of x is even. How do we check the given function is even? It satisfies the condition f of minus x is equal to f of x. After confirming that, for construction of Fourier series of f of x, we use a naught an. A naught formula is 2 by pi integral 0 to pi f of x dx. Why? Because this formula, here we use the property of definite integral, and an formula is 2 by pi integral 0 to pi f of x into cos nx. So obviously bn is equal to 0. The given function f of x is odd, it satisfies the condition f of minus x is equal to minus f of x. We find only bn. The formula for finding bn is 2 by pi integral 0 to pi into f of x sin nx into dx. Obviously a naught is equal to 0, an is equal to 0. See, we confirm the given function is even, we find only a naught an. We can write directly bn is equal to 0, but we use this formula. The given function f of x is odd, we find only bn. We can write directly a naught is equal to 0, an is equal to 0. So for examination point of view, in this particular unit, every problem to construct f of x, first we check the given function f of x is even or odd, then only we find a naught, an, bn. Okay, so now we are going to discuss in the problem by using even or odd nature of the given function f of x. Obtain Fourier series of f of x is equal to pi square minus x square in minus pi comma plus pi. In minus pi comma plus pi. Solution. First, we check f of x is even or odd nature. That is, f of x is pi square minus x square replace x by minus x, that is f of minus x is equal to pi square minus x whole square is equal to pi square minus x square is equal to f of x. See, pi square minus x square is equal to f of x. Therefore, f of minus x is equal to f of x. What is the condition? So, this condition for even nature. So, therefore, f of x is even. Therefore, f of x is even. That means what? We find only a naught and an. Obviously, bn equal to 0. So that means what? After confirming the given function f of x is even, we just find only a naught and an. You recall the formula for finding a naught after confirming the given function is even? 2 by pi integral 0 to pi. So this is very, very important. So if you are not checked the given function is even or odd nature, you can write, you can find all a naught an bn by using the formula a naught is equal to 1 by pi times integral minus pi to plus pi. So for avoiding the burden, you must check the given function f of x is even or odd nature. So a naught is equal to 2 by pi integral 0 to pi. The given function f of x is pi square minus x square into dx. That is equal to 2 by pi. So here single function is there. So integral pi square dx is pi square x. Integral x square is x cube by 3 0 to pi. That is equal to 2 by pi times pi square. You apply the limit for x, pi minus 0. Here minus 1 by 3 is common, pi cube minus 0. That is equal to 2 by pi times pi square into pi, pi cube minus pi cube by 3. That is equal to 2 by pi times 3 pi cube minus pi cube by 3. That is equal to 2 by pi common, 3 pi cube minus pi cube is 2 pi cube divided by 3. That is equal to pi pi cancel, 4 pi square divided by 3 is the required a naught. So actually we want a naught by 2. This a naught by 2 is there in Fourier series. That is equal to 2 pi square by 3 is the required a naught by 2. So next, after finding a naught, next we go for an. You recall the formula for finding an is 2 by pi integral 2 by pi integral 0 to pi f of x into cos nx dx. Cos nx dx. That is equal to 2 by pi integral 0 to pi given function f of x is pi square minus x square into cos nx dx. Cos nx dx. That is equal to 2 by pi common. You observe the given integral function involves two functions, first function, second function. So that is why integrating this means you apply Bernoulli's rule of integration by parts. You recall Bernoulli's rule of integration by parts. That means what? You write first function. Integrating the second function, you know, integration of cos nx is sin nx divided by n minus derivative of pi square minus x square is minus 2x, and integral of sin is minus cos nx by n square minus next plus derivative of minus 2x is minus 2, integral of minus cos nx is minus sin nx by n cube. Apply limit 0 to pi. Apply limit 0 to pi. So next step, an, apply 0 or pi for sine term is 0. So that is why you write 2 by pi. See here sine term 0, here also sine term 0. Next, here minus, minus into minus, plus into minus, minus, minus 1 by n square inside common cos n x, apply the limit 0 to pi, minus 2 by pi n square common, apply limit pi cos n pi, minus cos 0 is 1, minus 2 by pi n square, you know cos n pi is minus 1 power n, minus 1. Minus 1. So this is the required an. For convenient you write an is equal to, an is equal to 2 by pi n square 1 minus minus 1 power n. So this is the required an. So after finding a naught n, we construct Fourier series of f of x is equal to pi square minus x square is equal to 2 pi square by 3 plus summation n from 1 to infinity. An term is 2 by pi n square 1 minus of minus 1 power n into cos nx. So this is the required Fourier series. Required Fourier series. Next problem. Obtain, important, obtain the Fourier series of f of x is equal to mod x in minus pi comma plus pi, and hence deduce that pi square pi 8 is equal to 1 by 1 square plus 1 by 3 square plus 1 by 5 square plus etc. Solution. First, we check the given function f of x is equal to mod x is even or odd, even or odd nature. That is, f of x is equal to mod x, we know that mod x means plus x and minus x, plus x in 0 less than x less than pi, minus x in minus pi less than x less than 0. So plus x for positive side, minus x for negative side, for the interval minus pi to plus pi. So, but mod x is absolute value of x, means we consider only positive side of the given function f of x, that is plus x is in 0 to pi. Why we consider this? Because the given function satisfies the even nature, that is mod minus x means plus x is equal to f of x. Therefore, f of minus x is equal to f of x. Therefore, f of x is even. After confirming f of x is even, we write the integral function, that is 0 to pi. That is why we take plus x. Therefore, after confirming the given function f of x is even, we find only a naught. We find a naught and an. Obviously bn is equal to 0. Obviously bn is equal to 0. So now we find a naught. A naught formula is 2 by pi integral 0 to pi. We select plus x into dx that is equal to 2 by pi. You know, integral of x is x square by 2, 0 to pi, that is equal to 2 by pi, that is 1 by 2 inside common, pi square minus 0, 2 to cancel, 1 by pi outside common, pi square, pi pi cancel, pi. Therefore, a naught is pi, a naught by 2 is pi by 2, a naught by 2 is pi by 2. Next, an. An formula is 2 by pi integral 0 to pi f of x into cos nx into dx, that is equal to 2 by pi common integral 0 to pi f of x is x cos nx into dx, that is equal to 2 by pi common. You apply Bernoulli's rule of integration by parts because the integral function involves two terms. First term is x, second term is cos nx. You recall Bernoulli's rule of integration parts, that is you write first function integral of second function, that is sin nx by n minus derivative of first function is x is 1, integral sin is minus cos n x by n into n, n square. Next term will be 0 because derivative of constant is 0, 0 to pi. An is equal to, see, apply pi r 0 for sin 0, outside 2 by pi is there, minus into minus plus inside 1 by n square common, for convenient applying the limit, cos nx 0 to pi, that is 2 by pi integral, 1 by n square cos n pi minus cos 0 is 1. Cos 0 is 1. That is equal to 2 by pi outside, or you can take outside 1 by pi n square common, minus 1 power n is cos n pi minus 1. See, this is the required an solution. For series deduction, you rewrite one more step. An is equal to minus 2 by pi n square 1 minus minus 1 power n. Why? Because we have the value for 1 minus of minus 1 power n, that is equal to 2 if n is odd, n is odd is equal to 0 if n is even. That is why you write this step. So obviously bn is 0, we need not find because we confirmed the given function is even. Therefore, f of x is equal to a naught by 2 is pi by 2 plus summation n from 1 to infinity, an is minus 2 by pi n square 1 minus of minus 1 power n into cos nx. You call equation number 1. So this is the required Fourier series. Next, series deduction. Put x equal to 0 in 1. This 0 is lies within 0 to pi, 0 to pi, because of cos, we apply x equal to 0, cos 0 is 1, so you will get the series, I think. F of 0 is equal to 0, pi by 2, plus summation n from 1 to infinity, minus 2 by pi n square, 1 minus of minus 1 power n into cos 0 is 1. That is equal to, but 1 minus of minus 1 power n is equal to 2 if n is odd, 0 if n is even. We have the formula. We already discussed about this in previous problems. So 0 is equal to pi by 2 plus here minus 2 by pi outside common n from 1 to infinity minus 1 by, here minus already is there, 1 by n square. Here the value of 1 minus of minus 1 power n is 2. If n is odd, that is 1, 3, 5, etc. You take outside minus pi by 2, minus 2 by pi. Summation n from 1, 3, 5, etc. 2 by n square. Minus cancel. Pi square by 8. Pi square by 8 is equal to, expanding summation up by applying 1, 3, 5, etc. That is 1 by 1 square, 1 by 3 square, 1 by 5 square, plus etc. So this is the required series. Next problem. Expand the function f of x is equal to x sin x as a Fourier series in minus pi less than or equal to x less than or equal to plus pi. Solution: the Fourier series of f of x is given by f of x is equal to a naught by 2 plus summation n from 1 to infinity an cos nx plus summation n from 1 to infinity bn sin nx. First, we check the given function f of x is even or odd. That is, f of minus x is equal to minus x sine of minus x. Minus x, you know, sine of minus x is minus sine nx. Minus sine x. Minus into minus plus x sine x. That is equal to f of x. That means what? We confirm the given function f of x is even, because it satisfies the condition f of minus x is equal to f of x. That means what? We find only a naught and an. Obviously, bn is equal to 0. Now, a naught is equal to 2 by pi integral 0 to pi f of x is x sine x into dx. That is, a naught is equal to 2 by pi. Here also we have two functions. First function is x, second function is sine x. You apply Bernoulli's rule of integration by parts. X minus cos x minus 1 minus sine x 0 to pi. So sine term is 0. A naught is minus 2 by pi x cos x 0 to pi. That is equal to minus 2 by pi outside, pi cos pi minus 0 minus 2 by pi minus 1 power n. Pi cancel, minus 2 into minus. Here cos pi is minus 1, that is equal to 2. Here n is there, your power n, but here there is no n, you write minus 1, that is equal to 2. an naught is 2, a naught is 2, we want a naught by 2 is 1. Next, we find an. An formula is 2 by pi common, integral 0 to pi f of x is x sin x into cos nx dx. 2 by pi outside common.
So when we are evaluating the integral function involves
two functions, we apply Bernoulli's rule of integration by parts, but here the integral function involves three functions, that is x, sin x, cos nx. We don't have any rule for evaluating the integral by using three functions. So that means what? We are reducing three functions to two functions with the help of a trigonometric identity, that is using sin a cos b. The formula, you recall, sin a cos b is 1 by 2 times sin of a plus b plus sin of a minus b. See, using this trigonometric identity, we reducing three functions into two functions, that is an is equal to 2 by pi outside common integral 0 to pi x into, you apply the identity sin a cos b, that is 1 by 2 times sin of x plus nx plus sin of x minus nx. That is an is equal to outside 2 by pi common. Here inside 1 by 2 is there. 1 by 2 into 2 is 1. 1 by pi integral 0 to pi x into sin of x plus nx plus sin of x minus nx. That is an is equal to 1 by pi common integral 0 to pi x into, you take x common, 1 plus n of x sin of 1 minus n of x. That is equal to 1 by pi common integral 0 to pi x into sin of 1 plus n x. Here you write sin of 1 minus n is minus sin of n minus 1 by using the sin of minus theta is minus sin theta, that is x. You write one more step for convenient integration, that is integral 0 to pi, we can split into two functions, integral functions, x into sin of n plus 1 x minus integral 0 to pi x into sin of n minus 1 into x into dx into dx. That is equal to an is equal to 1 by pi times. So now you observe, we reducing two functions. First function is x, second function is sin of n plus 1 x. So now when we are going to evaluating the integral function involves two functions, you apply Bernoulli's rule of integration by parts. That is first function x, integral of sin is minus cos of n plus 1 x divided by n plus 1 minus derivative of x is 1, integral of cos is minus n plus 1 x divided by n plus 1 whole square minus, again integrating by parts, x into integration of sin is minus cos of n minus 1 by n minus 1 x minus derivative of x is 1, integral of cos is sin n minus 1 x by n minus 1 whole square. Apply the limit 0 to pi. An is equal to, see, 0 or pi, sine term is 0, outside 1 by pi common, inside minus 1 by n plus 1 common. Here x into cos of n plus 1 x 0 to pi minus into minus plus 1 by n minus 1 x cos of n minus 1 x 0 to pi.
So the next step,
an is equal to 1 by pi common minus 1 by n plus 1 pi cos of n plus 1 pi minus 0 plus 1 by n minus 1 pi cos of n minus 1 pi minus 0. An is equal to 1 by pi minus 1 by n plus 1 common pi into minus 1 power n plus 1. Here cos of n plus 1 pi is there, that is why. Plus 1 by n minus 1 common minus 1 power n minus 1 pi. Minus 1 power n minus 1 is there, n minus 1 minus 0. Here inside pi common, pi cancel, an minus 1 power n plus 1 divided by n plus 1 plus minus 1 power n minus 1 by n minus 1. That is equal to, here minus 1 means minus 1 power 1 n plus 2 n plus 1 plus minus 1 power n minus 1 by n minus 1, that is equal to, you can split minus 1 power n common, minus 1 power 2 by n plus 1, minus 1 power 1 minus 1 by n minus 1. You can stop up to this step, you will get full marks. Expanding this value of an like this, minus 1 power n, you know, minus 1 power 2 is 1 plus 1, minus 1 power minus 1 is minus n minus 1, minus 1 power n, simplify this, a plus b into a minus b, a square minus b square, minus 2 power n, n square minus 1, that is equal to an, that is equal to an. An is equal to minus 2
otherwise you write
minus or you write an 2 into minus 1 power n plus 1 by n square minus 1. So this is the required an.
You see, the Fourier series always n from 1 to infinity. Suppose put n is equal to
n is equal to 1, this an is invalid because 1 minus 1 0. So that is why this an value is 2 into minus 1 power n plus 1 by n square minus 1 is exist if n is not equal to 1. This condition is very, very important.
See, when we are solving an, you will get this, but because of denominator n is there, summation series is always starts from n from 1 to infinity. You apply n is 1, an is invalid. That is why you write the condition if n is not equal to 1. But we want n equal to 1. So you apply n is equal to 1. What happened here? A1 is equal to minus 1 power 2. 1 you apply an is 2 by pi integral 0 to pi. You don't apply n is equal to 1 for this series. You apply an formula, that is an is equal to 2 by pi integral 0 to pi f of x is x sin x into cos x cos nx dx. Here n is equal to 1, that is a1 2 by pi integral 0 to pi x sin x cos 1x dx. For convenient integration, you write sin x cos x is sin 2x by 2. I mean, we reducing 3 function into 2 function. We use the identity sin x cos x is sin 2x by 2. 2x by 2 into dx. A1 is it, we want A1 because summation starts from n from 1 to infinity, that is here 2 to cancel, 1 by pi integral 0 to pi x sin 2x dx. So apply Bernoulli's rule of integration by parts, that is x minus cos 2x by 2 minus 1 minus sin 2x by 4 0 to pi. So pi are 0 for sin 0. A1 is equal to minus 1 by 2 pi common x cos 2x 0 to pi. That is equal to minus 1 by 2 pi common pi cos 2 pi minus 0. That is equal to pi pi cancel, minus 1 by 2 common. You know cos 2 pi is plus 1. That is equal to minus half is required A1. So after finding A0, A1, An, A1, we construct the series. Therefore, f of x is equal to x sin x is equal to A0 by 2 is 1, A1 is 1 by 2. Into cos 1x plus summation starts from n is equal to 2 to infinity, that is 2 into minus 1 power n plus 1 divided by n square minus 1 into cos nx is the required Fourier series of the given function f of x is equal to x sin x. So I will continue in next class.